I had a great second grade teacher who believed I could write, and she assigned me every single day to tell her a story. And I was probably in the seventh grade before I realized I made mistakes. She never corrected my grammar, she never corrected my stories. She just said, "It's great, I love it, tell me another one." And it was too late. I was already hooked before I realized I was going to have to work hard to keep doing what I love to do. I'm Sandra Glahn, and I am a professor at Dallas Seminary. I edit Kindred Spirit magazine, and I have a writing and speaking ministry. My husband got his THM at Dallas Seminary in 1981, and when I started teaching women's Bible study, I would often grab him and say, "What does the Greek say here? What does the Hebrew say here?" And one day he left before I was able to grab him and ask his opinion, and I realized I really wanted to have the tools for myself if I was going to keep teaching the Bible, which I love to do. At that time, I was a freelance writer, and I found out that there was a writing class at Dallas Seminary. So I took it just for professional development, and I loved it. I was writing more for the secular market, and the thought of bringing a Christian worldview into what I was doing and to write from a Christian perspective was very exciting to me. It had an eternal purpose. My husband and I wanted four children, and we ended up with 3 years of no success, followed by 7 early pregnancy losses, followed by 3 failed adoptions. There were a number of books on the market about a Christian view of infertility at the time when my husband and I were going through our 10-year struggle. What was out there at the time either said, "Don't do anything high-tech," but it didn't tell me how to think about it. Or it said, "Anything goes," and I had a high view of life, and I was uncomfortable with some of the in vitro procedures. And so we had a Christian doctor who was a graduate of Dallas Theological Seminary who'd helped us work through some of the ethical issues. And I wanted to make that available to other people that wanted to think through the issues biblically. And that was that first book I pitched as part of a writing project to a publisher. Our personal suffering led me back to the text to relook at, starting in Genesis 1, who is woman? What was she made for? We were made for God. And it, again, I had an encouraging husband, so he had a bigger view of what I could do than I had for myself. And he was constantly encouraging me to think theologically, to explore my potential, to use my spiritual gifts, and all of those forces sort of came together. One of the things I tell students when they're getting ready to graduate is that when they get out in the field, they will say things like, "They didn't teach me that in seminary." And "They didn't teach me that in seminary 101 is, "I will be with you." Everything else is covered by, "I will be with you." And you need wisdom. So if my students or my readers leave knowing where to get the source of wisdom, I will be satisfied.